Remember, the goal is performance-efficient implementation of RVM. The restricted semantics of transaction help a lot in making sure that what we are designing as a reliable virtual memory is not very heavyweight. But the implementation of that reduced semantic has to be efficient as well. And that's part of the reason why this is called lightweight reliable virtual memory, to indicate that it's lightweight in terms of transactional properties. Now, how to make it really perform well? The first thing is the strategy that they use for recording changes to the persistent portion of the virtual memory. The logging strategy is what is called no undo redo value logging. No undo meaning that we are creating an undo record of the changes that we're going to make to virtual memory, but it is not a log that is persisted on the disk. It is just an in-memory copy that is kept only for the duration of the transaction. And at the end of the transaction, either it commits or aborts, we throw away that undo copy that we created. On the other hand, redo is the log that we create, first of all, in memory as a data structure in RVM. And we commit those data structure to memory. And in committing the changes of the redo logs, we are only writing the new value records of committed transactions to the log. So even though the redo log consists of a transaction start and the changes that you're making, only new value records of the committed transactions are written to the log. Now, this is the reason you have forward displacements that we know where to append to the log segment on the disk. There is an in-memory version of the log segment to which you're writing the redo logs. And once you've written the redo logs, you're flushing it to the disk. On the disk, you have an on-disk version of this redo log record for this particular process. And what you're doing at a commit point is only writing the new value records of the committed transactions at the tail of that log segment. So we're only appending to that log segment the new changes that have been made within this transaction. So upon commit, what we need to do is we have to replace the old value records in the virtual memory with the new value records. But this is automatic because the way LRVM works is that it has created an undo record of the old value records of that portion of the virtual address space, and all the changes that the developer is making to the persistent data structures in memory are happening in memory, and therefore replacing the old value records by the new value records in the virtual memory is automatic. Only if you abort, you have to undo the changes. But if you're committing, then your virtual memory is already ready to go in terms of the changes that are being made within the transaction. And at that point, you have to force the redo log records to the log on the disk. And as I mentioned earlier, the optimization that's available in the implementation is to get transactions on the cheap. In particular, the no restore optimization allows the implementation not to create an in-memory undo record. That's time saved in terms of copying, and that means better performance for the application. And similarly, no flush at commit point tells RVM that it can write the redo log to the disk lazily and does not have to block the process that is making that call, the end transaction call, and that is an opportunity, again, to make that implementation more performance conscious. So this lazy commitment, of course, has its downside. There is this window of vulnerability that I mentioned, and that is there is a time window between end transaction and the point at which the redo log has been forced to the disk, and this is the window of vulnerability, and if the system crashes within this time, then we've lost the redo records that we wrote to in memory. And that is important to understand, that there is a price you pay in order to get this flexibility and performance in the implementation. You can see that this redo log data structure allows traversal in both directions, and this is for flexibility in implementing the RVM runtime, in particular, writing to the on-disk version of this redo log. Having these forward displacements allows you to know where exactly you want to append to the existing redo log record from the changes that have been done in this particular transaction and being committed at this point of time. And similarly, the reverse displacements are helpful in traversing the log record during recovery.